class we are transistor. So in the seen that all the currents are incoming currents, IE, IB and IC are incoming currents. In some of the textbook that you refer, and the current directions might be slightly different, something like you might observe that IE might be incoming whereas IB and IC are outgoing currents. Okay, so only follow to one notation. Okay, so do not look for different textbooks. Different textbooks will follow different notation, sign notations. Okay, because of which you may get confused. So stick to one single sign notation. Okay, the only difference you may observe is that you may get additional minus sign in the equations based upon the notation that you have used. Okay, so magnitude wise everything will be the same. So if you are getting the minus sign in the answer, means that your assumption is opposite to that of the exact current direction. So if, for example, if you are getting if you're solving a problem and you're getting that IC as a negative value, it means that IC is not an incoming current, but IC will be a outgoing current. A negative current means that IB is a outgoing current. Okay, so stick to one notation. So this notation I have taken from Milman Hawkins textbook, which is your preferred textbook. So if you're going for some other book like Sanjeev Gupta, so there the notations are entirely different. Okay, so what I have done is I have used only the notations as per this Milman Hawkins textbook, in which all the currents are taken as incoming currents. Okay, now also we have derived some factors like emitter efficiency gamma, transport factor beta, and then large signal current gain alpha. We are seeing that relationship between alpha, beta and gamma as alpha is equal to beta star into gamma. Okay, so this alpha is not a constant parameter, but it varies with the emitter current. Okay, if the emitter current is increasing, your alpha will also be changing. Okay, so alpha will depend upon emitter current IE and collector voltage VCB, and also on the temperature. So alpha, you should not take it as a constant value. So alpha will be constant as long as your emitter current IE, VCB and temperature are constant. Okay, in we have transistor operating three different regions called active region, cutoff region and saturation region. Usually we are operating the transistor in active region. Active region means that your emitter junction is forward bias and collector junction is reverse bias. Okay, in such a scenario we get the equation as IC equal to minus alpha E plus IC naught. How did we arrive at this equation? From the definition of your alpha. Please mute yourself. So from this definition, alpha equal to minus IC, minus IC naught by IE. So if I rearrange this equation, if I pull this minus under the other sign, minus alpha IE equal to IC minus IC naught. From this, IC is equal to minus I alpha IE plus IC naught. So this is how you got this equation. So in which your IC naught is nothing but your constituents of your leakage current. So predominantly it's your reverse saturation current. Okay, because your collector junction is reverse biased. In case if your collector junction is not reverse biased, it may be having either forward bias or reverse bias. So if you want to generalize this equation, you can replace this IC naught with IC naught into 1 minus e power VC by VT. Okay, so instead of IC naught, why we are writing this is, this is nothing but your collector junction acting like a diode. You know that diode equation, current equation, if you remember, I is equal to I naught into 1 minus e power V by eta VT. Okay, so if you are considering that eta is equal to 1, then it will be I naught into 1 minus e power V by VT. Okay, So where I naught is your reverse current. So reverse saturation current or your leakage current, that way I'm writing it as minus IC naught. And E power V is the voltage of the junction. Okay. So here the junction that we are now checking is your collector junction. So you are writing that collector voltage BC by VT. Okay. So for the collector circuit, we are writing it as this current is IC naught into 1 minus E power VC by VT. In case your if your collector voltage is a reverse bias voltage, that is negative voltage, then obviously it will come back to your nearly equal to minus IC naught. Okay. So IC naught. Okay, reverse saturation current. If your VC is a large value, a negative value, this term will become zero and you will be getting with IC nearly equal to IC naught. Okay, so that's why we are writing in this. So it's a generalized equation, but usually we will write, usually in active region, collector is reverse bias and we'll be writing IC is equal to minus alpha E plus IC naught. We'll move on to the next topic. Next topic is transistor acting as an amplifier. Is my screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So again, we'll come back to the original circuit in which we have a base terminal common to both the input and output circuits. So in this circuit, we'll just see how it acts like an amplifier. So generalized overview of transistor as an amplifier. Okay. So we are connecting a load resistor in the collector circuit that is in series with your VCC. And then we are having a small voltage in the input terminals. So input is between your emitter and base. So we are having a small change in the input voltage. That small change, we are considering writing it as delta VI, okay? And then which will obviously result in a change in your emitter current, delta IE. So if you are changing the input voltage, definitely you will see the change in the input current, okay? So you will be observing a change in the input current that is represented by delta IE. Now we'll define a symbol alpha, okay, which is now written as alpha will be defined as change in out current, output current to the change in input current. Okay. So we'll define that and which will be called as the fraction of the current change collected at the load resistor RL. Okay. So now change in output voltage can be written as, so you know that what is the change in output voltage? Delta V naught will be written as, I can write it as delta IC, that is a change in output current into your RL. Okay. So this delta IC is nothing but, already we defined that alpha dash as change in output by change in input current. Okay. So now I will write it as alpha dash as delta IC by delta E. So now we'll write delta IC as alpha dash into delta IE into RL. That's what we are writing here. Delta V naught is equal to alpha dash into RL into delta I. Okay. Now if you want to find out the amplification, amplification is for a given input, what how much the output has been raised or declined, that will be seen. Okay. So ratio of the output voltage to the input voltage. So if it is greater than 1, then we'll call it as an amplification. Okay. So if this A value is less than 1, then we cannot call it as an amplifier. We want that signal to be increased in magnitude. Okay. That's why always this A value should be greater than 1 if it has to act as an amplifier. Okay. So what we'll be doing is we'll be writing A as delta V naught by delta VI, we can write that, or directly V naught by VI if you are not changing the signal. So if you are replacing these values over here, so delta V naught is, what is the delta V naught value? Alpha dash RL IE delta E and delta VI. So in the delta VI, you have only a the change in current delta E into resistance. The resistance between your emitter and base circuit is nothing but your forward biased diode. So diode is nothing but your emitter base junction. So emitter is a p-type material, base is n-type material. So in between this, you have only one small resistance, that is your diode resistance. So we have a diode for dynamic resistance represented by Re dash, because it's the resistance of the emitter junction. I'm writing it as Re dash. Okay, so delta VI is equal to delta E into Re dash. Now if you divide delta V naught by delta VI, you'll be getting alpha dash RL delta E by Re dash delta E. Okay, delta E gets cancelled and you will be left out with alpha dash RL by Re dash. You know that load resistor that we connect will be in the order of kilo ohms, whereas your Re dash is simply your dynamic resistance of your diode, which is a very small value, maybe in the order of ohms. Okay, so definitely your denominator is a small value and the numerator is a very large value. So your A will be always greater than 1. So that's why I can say that a transistor can act like a amplifier. So if your A is greater than 1, then your amplification is existing. If the A is less than 1, then you cannot call it as an amplifier. Okay. So what we are basically doing is, from the input circuit, we have a low resistance. This is a low resistance input circuit. We are moving towards a high resistance output circuit. Okay. So current in low input resistance circuit is transferred to the high resistance output circuit. This kind of transfer of resistance, we are calling it as the transistor. Okay. So current is changing from a low input resistance circuit to a high resistance output circuit. So this kind of action is known as transistor action. So let us consider the dynamic resistance. So if you remember the dynamic resistance, at room temperature, your Re dash, your dynamic resistance is nearly equal to volt equivalent of temperature by IE. Okay, so this volt equivalent of temperature is 26 millivolt. Okay, at room temperature, if you remember, do you remember that at room temperature I told you that the volt equivalent of temperature is 26 millivolt? Do you remember that? So that's why we are representing that in the numerator, we are representing by 26. So at room temperature, Re dash is equal to 26 by IE. Okay, so where IE is your quiescent emitter current. So the term quiescent, I will explain it later times, where I will be discussing about the graphical solution for this transistor characteristics. Okay, so for now, you just remember that I is simply the emitter current. You omit the term quiescent for time being. We'll discuss about this quiescent at a later part of time. Now, let us take an example. Re dash is a small value, and let the dynamic resistance of the input circuit or the emitter is 40 ohms, and then alpha dash is equal to minus 1, and then RL is equal to 3000 ohms. Okay, so if you replace these values in the previous previous formula we have used, A equal to alpha dash we have written as minus 1. And then RL we have taken as 3000 ohms divided by Re dash we have taken as 40. So 475. So A is equal to minus 75. So you are able to amplify the voltage by 75 times. Okay. This you can forget about this minus sign. So minus sign only indicates that our initial assumption of the current directions is are not correct. So instead of the collector current going in, actually the collector current is going out from the transistor. That's the only difference that we are seeing. okay, and then we have defined this. So usually they'll say that if the alpha is independent of IE, your alpha dash is equal to minus alpha. Okay, so all these are positive values. So if you want to write it as a positive value, then you can write it as alpha dash is equal to minus alpha. So now what we'll be doing is we'll be discussing three different circuit configurations for the transistors and amplifier. Is this PPT visible to you? Is PPT visible to you? Yes, right. Okay. So, please mute yourself. So, we have actually three different configurations for a transistor: common base configuration, common emitter configuration, and then common collector configuration. Common collector configuration. Okay. So, for all these configurations, you will have different circuits for the PNP transistor and NPN transistor. But whenever I'm delivering the class, I'm only taking the PNP transistor as my model. Okay. So you can also have an analogous NPN transistor. Okay. So everything else will be the same. Only thing is that your arrow mark between the emitter and base will be slightly different. And the equations you may get the signs as different. Okay. You may get a negative symbol or a positive symbol. Small difference might be there, but more or less the operation will be the same, the explanation will be the same. So in your examination, he may ask you the NPN transistor or a PNP transistor. You should be able to write for both. Okay, so but as far as the explanation that I am delivering, I'm only considering the PNP transistor. Okay, so for the PNP transistor, in the common base configuration, you have the base terminal common to both the input circuit and output terminal circuit. Okay, so here is your input terminals. These are your output terminals. In between you have your base. So base is your n-type material now in a PNP. So what will be your input voltage? You have to tell me the input voltage. Please respond, what's the input voltage? Please respond, what is the input voltage? You have two terminals. What are the input terminals now? Please respond. What are the input terminals?
VEB, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So your input voltage will be VEB. Okay. So while you are drawing the transistor characteristics, you should keep this in mind. Okay. That's why I'm specifically mentioning this. And what will be your input current? Input current will be your IE. So input current will be your IE. Similarly, if you go for the output circuit, in the output circuit, your output voltage is, your output voltage will be VCB between collector and base terminals, and output current IC. Okay, so based upon the direction of the current in the inner actual analysis, you may get a plus IC or minus IC, that we shall leave for time being. Okay, so if you want to write then the actual symbols in the actual circuit diagram, you can represent like this. So you have a p-type emitter, n-type base, and again p-type collector. Okay, always the arrow mark will be added from p-type region to the n-type region. Okay, that too between the emitter and base. Your base is grounded. Okay, and if you go for the common emitter configuration, you have to tell me the now the input voltage. This is your PNP transistor. In the common emitter configuration, your emitter is common to both input and output circuits. Okay, you have to tell me the input voltage now. What is the input voltage? What will be your input voltage? Please respond.
VBE.
VBE. Okay. So if you just check with the previous configuration, in the previous configuration it was VEB, now it is VBE. Okay, that you should keep it in mind. Okay, so it is input voltage is VBE and then input current now will be your IB. Okay, similarly output voltage, what will be your output voltage? So output is between your collector and emitter, right? So it will be VCE. And what will be your output current? Output current will be IC. Okay, output current will be IC. This your actual circuit looks like this. So this your symbol for your PNP transistor, in which emitter terminal is common to both the input and output circuit. So next we have common collector configuration. In the common collector configuration, your collector terminal is common to both input and output. Okay. So what will be your input voltage now? What will be your input voltage now for this configuration? Your input voltage will be equal to, please respond, what is your, will be your input voltage?
VBC, sir.
VBC. Input current?
VB.
IB.
Similarly, what will be your output voltage? Output is between emitter and collector. So what will be the output voltage? Output voltage will be equal to VEC.
EC.
And output current will be? Output current will be equal to IE. Okay. So these are very much required while you are drawing the transistor characteristics. Okay. So where you'll keep some of these terms, like, so when you are writing a input characteristics, you have to write between input voltage versus input current, keeping output terms as constant. Okay, when you're drawing the output characteristics, you have to draw between output voltage versus output current, input factors as constant. Okay, so that's why I'm specifically mentioning these things. Okay, now coming to the common base configuration. So first we'll be studying the common base, next we'll go on to the common emitter, and then we'll move on to the common collector configuration. So in the common base configuration, so this is how your actual circuit looks like. You will be giving your signal. So not only your battery voltage, you may have to apply the AC signal also. Okay, that's why I'm giving that signal at the input terminals, and I'm keeping a load resistor at the output terminals. Okay, so given all the current directions such a way that all the currents are incoming currents. Okay, and then I have the base terminal common to both input circuit and output circuit. Now we'll define a current amplification factor alpha. So when there's no signal, so when the signal is zero, you have only the battery voltages, that's the DC voltages are there. In such a scenario, the ratio of the collector current to the emitter current is called DC alpha of the transistor. So alpha DC is equal to minus IC by IE. Okay, minus IC by IE. So I'm writing this minus sign because all these currents are only incoming. Okay, so always your current, your alpha should be a positive value. Okay, in some of the textbooks they might have given alpha DC as directly IC by IE. Okay, in such a scenario current will be outgoing current. So for this notation that I have taken, your alpha DC equal to minus IC by IE. Okay, so from this, so if you rewrite, IC will be equal to minus alpha DC into IE. And now you have from KCL equation. So if you take that transistor as a black box, the entire transistor as a black box, if you consider, you have three currents going in. So if you consider this as a single node, okay, You have three currents going in, IA, IB, and IC, right? So what will be the KCL here now? KCL will be equal to that sum of the all the currents should be equal to zero. So because all the currents are incoming currents, I'm writing it as IE plus IB plus IC equal to zero. Okay, this is your KCL equation. So from this, I can write IB equal to minus IE minus IC. Now here I'll be rewriting IC as minus alpha DC into IE. So this equation I'm going to replace over here. So from this, what I am going to get is IB equal to this minus minus becomes the plus, or I will take the minus sign common. So if I take the minus sign common, this will become minus of 1 minus alpha DC into IE. Okay, so this is the relationship between your IB and base current and emitter current. Next, when the signal is applied, then we call the amplification as alpha AC. So here only thing we will be doing is that because we have a signal changing signal which is not constant, which is going to change, we will be writing it as minus delta IC by delta IE, where your VCB is kept constant. Okay. This is a change in output current to the input current, keeping your output voltage as constant. This is your output voltage is kept constant. Okay, this is your current amplification factor. Only thing is that the between alpha DC and alpha AC, the only difference is that you are taking the changes into consideration. Okay, now practically saying that alpha AC value and alpha DC value both will be positive, and will be now from now on we'll be writing it as alpha only. And for a commercial transistor, alpha will be very near to the 1, and it will be usually ranging from 0.9 to 0.99. So it is very close to 1. So I mean to say that, so almost the entire emitter current will reach the collector. Okay. And now if you want to write the total collector current, IC. So already we have written the previous time, we have written the equation IC as minus alpha IE plus IC naught, where IC naught is your leakage current, right? So because it is a common base configuration, we'll be writing it as ICB naught. Okay. So we'll be writing the leakage current as ICB naught. So most of the times this is very small and is neglected. Only if you're neglecting, your alpha will become equal to alpha DC. And then now we have to deal with the common emitter configuration. If you check the common emitter configuration, you have your emitter terminal common to both the input and output terminals. This is your Eger signal is given at the input terminals. You are taking the output across your load resistor. Okay, so here your input current is IB, output current is IC, your input voltage is VBE, output voltage is okay. Defining one more current amplification factor, beta. So beta DC is equal to, so here what is the current amplification? Output current by input current, right? So what is the output current here? What's the output current over here? Please respond. What's your output current?
IC.
IC. Yeah. Input current is?
IB.
IB. So,
IB.
So when there's no signal, we'll be writing the current amplification. It's nothing but output current by input current, that is equal to IC by IB. Okay, this is called a beta DC. So in case if you are taking into consideration even the changes in the signal, if you're considering the signal, then your beta AC will be equal to delta IC by delta IB, keeping your output voltage as constant. Here, what is your output voltage? VCE. Okay, at constant VCE, you can define your beta IC as delta IC by delta IB. Okay. That's what. So even here you have to mention that it is at constant VC. Okay. So when the signal is applied, that will be your beta IC. So the, this base current delta IB will be a very small current. Why this delta IB or the base current is a very small current? I told you the reason in the previous class itself. Why your IB will be very small current?
Base
is very lightly doped, that's one reason. Second reason is that base is very narrow. Okay, so overall concentration of your electrons in the base is very less, and the usual end of obviously your recombination will be less, and the recombination will be compensated by this base current. So IB will be very less. So in general, the base current is almost less than 5% of your emitter current. Okay, so for example, if you're taking the emitter current as 100 milliamperes, your base current will, if you're taking the emitter current as 100 milliamperes, your base current will be less than 5 milliamperes. Okay, so base current is very small. Okay, that's why if you have a very small base current and a very large, so for example, I have taken the example as I already told that your almost entire emitter current will be, you can observe at the collector terminals. So this will be IC will be again rated as nearly equal to emitter current. So I am taking the emitter current as 100 milliamperes, and base current I have told that it will be less than 5 milliamperes. If I take 5 milliamperes, so at least the beta value will be 20. Okay. So usually your beta will be greater than 20, and it will be ranging between usually between 20 and 500. So beta will be a large number. Whereas your alpha, if you take alpha, alpha will be a small number, usually close to 1. So alpha value is varying between 0.9 to 0.99, whereas your beta value is varying between 20 to 500, based upon what type of transistor you are taking. Okay. So beta is a large number. Okay, now if you consider the total collector current, that's your output current, I can write it as IC equal to beta IB plus, I'll represent the leakage current by the new term ICE naught. So this is the leakage current ICE naught. So I need to write, I need to find out what will be my ICE naught now. Okay, so again I will write the KCL equation. KCL equation is that IE plus IB plus IC equal to 0. Sum of all the incoming currents is equal to 0. Now again, I have my equation IC equal to minus alpha E plus ICB naught. So this is in your, this ICB naught is different from ICE naught. This ICB naught is from common base configuration. Okay. Initially, we are taking the common base configuration as reference. Now, if I rewrite, so in place of IE, now I'll be, what I'll be doing is I'll be rewriting IE as, in place of IE, I'll be writing it as minus IB minus IC. Okay. If I do that, IC equal to minus alpha into minus IB minus IC plus ICB naught. Okay. Now we'll take all the IC terms to the left hand side. So I have the minus alpha into minus IC, that is plus alpha IC. That if I bring it to the left hand side, it will become minus alpha IC. So it becomes IC minus alpha IC is IC into 1 minus alpha on the left hand side. On the right hand side, you have minus alpha into minus IB, that is plus alpha IB, and then you have your ICB naught. Now if I divide this equation by 1 minus alpha, this becomes IC equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha into IB plus ICB naught by 1 minus alpha. Now if we compare this with the previous equation that IC equal to beta IB plus IC naught, you'll be getting that beta is nearly equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha. So if you compare the coefficients, okay. So and then your IC naught equal to ICB naught by 1 minus alpha. Okay. So if you take this beta equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha, this relationship you should remember, because you will be dealing with the numerical problems. Now if you add 1 on both sides, 1 plus beta equal to 1 plus alpha by 1 minus alpha, if you take the LCM, it becomes 1 minus alpha plus alpha by 1 minus alpha. Plus minus alpha goes cancel. So 1 plus beta, you will get it as 1 by 1 minus alpha. So your beta equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha, and then IC naught equal to 1 plus beta by ICB naught. So these are your, this your leakage current in common emitter configuration, whereas ICB naught is the leakage current in common base configuration. So I can say that leakage current in common emitter configuration is much larger than leakage current in common base configuration. Again, we there are some questions, sometimes a relation between alpha and beta are asked, so that's why I specifically mention it as a separate heading. So you have alpha is equal to minus IC by IE, beta equal to IC by IB. Okay, so if we rewrite IB in place of IP, if you write it, rewrite as minus IE minus IC from your KCL equation. Okay, because IE plus IB plus IC equal to 0. Okay, if you rewrite that, you will get this. If you take your minus sign to the numerator, you'll get minus IC by IE plus IC. Now I can write minus IC as alpha into IE. Okay, and I will write again here IC as minus alpha IE. So I'll be getting beta equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha. So you can derive like this, or you can directly represent in this manner. Anything is the same. Okay. So from this, if you do the component and dividend of, you'll get that alpha equal to beta by 1 plus beta. Okay. So you know about component and dividend of? Do you know about component and dividend of? In your mathematics, this beta by 1 equal to alpha, yes, by 1 minus alpha. So if we add and add the numerators or subtract the denominators, we will have the same ratio, right? So I'll be doing for this, what I'll be doing is I'll be leaving this in this manner, and then I'll be writing 1 plus beta equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha plus alpha. Okay, so I'll be getting alpha equal to beta by 1 plus beta. That's how I get this. Also, you can write 1 minus alpha equal to 1 by 1 plus beta. So these relationships you need to practice, because some numerical problems will be asked. So once the topic is covered, is finished, I will be giving you some kind of numerical example problems for you to solve. And next, finally, we have your common collector configuration. Okay, so in the common emitter configuration, you'll be seeing that current gain, both the current gain beta is a large value, and also your voltage gain will be a greater than 1. So your common emitter configuration is the most preferred configuration as an amplifier. Okay, so wherever you want to use transistor as amplifier, mostly we'll be using common emitter configuration. Okay. So out of the three configurations, the most preferred configuration for a transistor amplifier is your common emitter configuration. And then we'll be moving on to the common collector configuration. So you need to tell me what is the common terminal over here. Please respond. What is the common terminal now? Please respond. What is the common terminal? for the input and output circuits?
Collector.
Correct.
Collector.
Now you the input correct.
IB.
What's the input IB. Current? IB. IB. IB is your input current. Okay. Input. Okay. What is your output current? What is your output sir. Current?
IE.
Okay. Now your current amplification will be the ratio of your output to the input. Okay. So your gamma DC is equal to minus IE by IB. Okay. So your gamma D is equal to minus IE by IB when no signal is applied. When a signal is applied, it will be minus delta IE by delta IB when output voltage is constant. So what is output voltage over here? What's output voltage? What's output voltage from the circuit?
VEC, sir.
VEC. Yeah, VEC. Yes. So the gamma is equal to minus delta E by delta IB when VEC is equal to, is constant, is maintained constant. Okay. Now because here your output current is delta E, which is almost nearly equal to your delta IC. So I can say that your current gain in the common emitter configuration and current gain in the common collector configuration are almost the same. Okay. So your beta will be nearly equal to your gamma. So more or less it will be the same values. Okay. However, here I will be seeing that the voltage gain, if you check the voltage gain, that is the ratio of your delta VEC by delta VBC. So what is your voltage gain? Your voltage gain will be equal to change in output voltage by change in input voltage. If you consider this value, your output is delta VEC. Input voltage is delta VBC. Okay. If you consider this value, you will be observing that your voltage gain will be less than 1. This will be a low value. Okay. That's why for voltage gain, wherever you are using it as amplifier, you will not prefer the common collector configuration. Okay. However, it will be used for impedance matching. So if you go for the application point of view, as amplifier, the most preferred configuration is common emitter configuration. But for impedance matching, your most preferred is your common collector configuration. Because here, input resistance is high. Input resistance is high. Whereas output resistance is low compared to the input resistance. Okay. So why your input resistance is high? Why your input resistance is very high? Can you tell me why the input resistance is high? Why?
Can you say light it up?
No, why you are telling for everything? Why it's not about the doping. I'm asking why your input resistance is high. So what is your input circuit here? Input circuit is between your base and collector, right? Input resistance is between your base and collector. Your base and collector is in which type of configuration? Forward bias or reverse bias?
Reverse bias configuration.
So reverse bias configuration. Since reverse bias, you know that resistance offered by the diode, if you are taking a simple PN junction diode, resistance offered in the reverse bias is very large, right? Compared to the resistance offered in the forward bias. In the resistance offered in the forward bias only in the range of ohms. Whereas the resistance offered in the reverse bias will be in the hundreds of kilo ohms will be there. Okay. It's almost like a off circuit. Right, so your input resistance is very high, whereas your output circuit here it is low. So obviously your amplification, voltage amplification will be less than 1. So you will never use the common collector configuration for voltage amplification. Okay, however, you will be using it for impedance matching. So when you want to drive a low impedance load from a high impedance source, you can use the common collector configuration. Okay. Now coming to the output current, say the output current is IE. So we'll be writing the equation for the total emitted current. Okay. So again, if you write the KCL equation, you have IE plus IB plus IC is equal to zero. And from this, I'll write also, I have the equation IC equal to minus alpha IE plus ICB naught. Okay. Now what I'll be doing is, in place of IC, I'll be writing this term. Okay. Now I'll be taking the IE terms common to the left hand side. I will be pushing all the other terms to the right hand side. So IE into 1 minus alpha is equal to plus IB will become minus IB on the right hand side, plus ICB naught will become minus ICB naught on the right hand side. So I'll take the minus sign common. Okay. Then IE equal to minus of IB by 1 minus alpha. I'm pushing this 1 minus alpha term to the right hand side. So it goes to the denominator. So it becomes IE equal to minus of IB by 1 minus alpha plus ICB naught by 1 minus alpha. Okay. Already in the previous slide, we have written that 1 minus alpha is equal to 1 by 1 plus, or from this I can write that 1 plus beta equal to 1 by 1 minus alpha. Okay. So wherever I have 1 by 1 minus alpha, I will be representing it by 1 plus beta. Okay. So this will become, this term will become 1 plus beta into IB. This term will become 1 plus beta into ICB naught. Now, if you compare this, now it will be something like I is equal to minus gamma IB minus of gamma IB plus ICC naught. Okay. I can write that leakage current in the common collector configuration. Okay. So from gamma is equal to 1 plus beta. So gamma value will be numerically equal to 1 plus beta. So if your beta is equal to, let us say 50, your gamma will be equal to 51. Okay. If your beta value is equal to 100, your gamma value will be equal to 101. Okay. So if you want to, next is the relationship between alpha, beta and gamma. Okay. So we have alpha is equal to minus IC by IE, gamma equal to minus IE by IB. Okay. So from this gamma equation, I'll be rewriting IB as minus IE minus IC. Okay. If I rewrite, this minus minus sign gets cancelled. It will be IE by IE plus IC. Now if you divide numerator and denominator with IE, numerator becomes 1. The denominator, this term become 1. This term will be IC by IE. Know that alpha is equal to minus IC by IE. So IC by IE, I'll write it as minus alpha. So your gamma equal to 1 by 1 minus alpha is equal to 1 plus beta. So this is a relationship between your alpha, beta and gamma. Gamma is equal to 1 by 1 minus alpha is equal to 1 plus beta. Okay. So with this, this topic as transistors, amplifiers in different configurations is over. But however, we need to solve some numerical problems. Okay. So I'll be giving you some problems. I'll be dictating you. You can please write it down now. And with that, we can solve. Okay. So please wait for a minute. Now we'll be discussing these problems in a whiteboard. If you have any doubts regarding this topic, you can ask me in the meanwhile. If you have any doubts, you can unmute and ask. Okay. So you have no doubts? Then we'll discuss one problem and then we can disperse. Okay. Is the question number 6 visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So please write down that question. 6A. Question number 6A. If the base current in a transistor is 20 microamperes, so these are some of the questions we are dealt for your seniors in A1 regulation. So the base current in a transistor is 20 microamperes when the emitter current is 6.4 milliamperes. What are the values of alpha DC and beta DC? Also determine the collector current. So shall we solve this problem? Is my screen visible now?
Yes, sir.
So first what we need to do is we need to write the data given the question. Given data is base current. What's the base current given? Base current IB is equal to 20 microamperes, right? And then emitter current IE is equal to 6.4 milliamperes. So we need to find out alpha DC, beta DC, and then IC. Okay, so first we have to find out, so what is alpha DC value? Alpha DC value is equal to minus IC by IE, and then beta DC value is equal to IC by IB. Okay, so for to find out either alpha DC or beta DC, we need to find out what is IC. So to find out IC, we need to go back to our KCL equation. Okay, so if you take the circuit. So we'll go back to the PNP transistor. So PNP transistor, you have this is your IE. We are taking this as IB. This we have taken IC, right? So what should be your KCL equation? KCL equation should be IE plus IB plus IC is equal to 0. Okay. So, but however, I also told you that your IB is a negative value, should be a negative value, because what is actually happening is whenever there's a recombination is happening, this will be compensated. So electrons lost will be you're getting back from this terminal battery voltage. So electrons will be moving from the external circuit towards the base. So what should be your conventional current direction? If the electrons are moving from the external circuit towards the transistor, what should be your conventional current direction? What should be a conventional current direction? Please respond. What should be a conventional current direction? So what is a conventional current direction? Please respond. What is said to be the conventional current direction? So conventional current direction is the direction of the current opposite to that of the movement of your electrons. Okay. Or I can say that if it's in the direction of your holes. Okay. So if the electrons are moving from external circuit towards the base, your current, conventional current direction should be from base towards the external circuit. However, because we are considered all the currents as incoming currents only, but in reality your current should have been the outgoing current. Okay, so for this region, so whenever we are using this KCL equation, consider your base current as a negative value only. So in place of 5B, you have to replace with minus 20 microamperes. So IE is equal to 6.4 milliamperes. IB you will be writing it as minus 20 microamperes, and then you'll be writing IC equal to 0. Okay. So what is 6.4 milli minus 20 micro? What is 6.4 minus 20 micro? So if I multiply with 10 power 3 and I can write it as 6400 into 10 power minus 6. Or I write as 6400 microamperes. Can I write like this? So how do you convert milli to micro? So what I'll be doing is I'll be multiplying with 10 power minus 10 power 3, and then I'll be writing with my 10 power minus 3 into milliamp. So this will be your microamperes, right? So this 6.4 into 1000. 6.4 will be equal to 6400 microamperes minus 20 microamperes plus IC equal to 0. So it is 6380 microamperes plus IC equal to 0. So IC equal to minus 6380 microamperes, or I can write IC is equal to minus 6.38 milliamperes. So we are getting the current as minus. It means that our assumption that current IC is an incoming current is not correct. So current IC should be an outgoing current. Okay. So in the final answer, you only mention that collector current is equal to collector current IC is magnitude is equal to 6.38 milliamperes. Okay. So I am only following the notation because in your reference textbook Millimans, it is given all currents as incoming currents. Otherwise, in generally speaking, for a PNP transistor, your IE will be incoming current, whereas your IB and IC should be outgoing currents. Okay. So it depends upon which convention you want to follow. You can follow. If you're following this, you need not worry about signs at all. But if you're following this, you should specifically mention that IBS negative. Okay. And so that you'll be ending up with ICS negative value. Okay. So if you're taking this kind of a sign notation, you can write incoming current is equal to outgoing current. So I is equal to IB plus IC. Okay. So either stick to this convention or to the convention given in your Milman-Hawkins. Okay. Do not mix the both the conventions. Stick to only one sign convention, which is easy to follow. Okay. So you're getting ICS 6.38 milliamperes. So what will be your alpha DC value? Alpha DC value will be equal to minus of IC by IE. So IC, I'm getting it as minus 6.38 milliamps. By IE, it is given as 6.4 milliamperes. So milli gets cancelled. So alpha DC equal to 6.38 by 6.4. That is nearly equal to 0.996875. Okay. So we got the value as 0.99, right? So obviously our assumption, already we told that range of alpha will be very close to 1, between 0.9 to 0.99. So our assumptions are, our values are correct. So you can verify your answers also. Okay. So alpha will never be greater than 1. Okay, so in case if I missed to keep this as minus 20, if I keep it as plus 20, it would have been 6.42. So alpha DC would have been 6.42 by 6.4. That will be greater than 1. That is never possible. Always alpha will be less than 1. Okay, that's why sign convention is very much important, which you need to take care. And then you have beta DC. So beta DC is equal to, so you know that beta is equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha. You can either do that way or you can directly write from the equations. Okay. So if you would directly want to write from the definition, beta, what is beta DC? Beta DC is equal to IC by IB. Okay. So IC by IB is IC is equal to minus 6.38 milliamperes. IB is equal to minus 20 microamperes. Okay. So this is 6380 microamperes by 20 microamperes. Micro gets cancelled. Minus gets cancelled. So beta value is equal to 319. Okay. So because your beta value is greater than 20 and less than 500, your beta value is also correct. Okay. So you should not get very large value like thousands. Okay. You should not get very small value like 1 or 2. Okay, it should be a large number. Your alpha should be close to 1. Your beta should be between 20 to 500. If you're getting the answer in such a way, then your answer is correct. Otherwise, it is wrong. Okay. So with this, we'll end this example. We'll solve some more problems in the next class and then move on to the transistor characteristics. Okay. So if you have any doubts, you can ask, or otherwise I'll close this. So I'll take the attendance.